Hi there, I'm Kelly Dean from the Tummy Team, and this video is going to talk to you a lot about diastasis recti and what it looks like in men. So diastasis recti is a separation of the abdominal wall. So you have that connective tissue that runs right down the center of your abdominal wall, and that connective tissue can get stretched out and cause a separation between the right and the left side. And this is a really common condition in women, mostly related to pregnancy because the dramatic change in the belly with pregnancy and postpartum, but it is also pretty common in men. And there's not a lot of information out there for men. The Tummy Team actually specializes in treating this, and we have online programs for everybody to treat this condition. And we have a specifically designed program for men. So we're going to do a series of educational, informational videos so that men don't feel left out. So you know what is going on, and you can have hope that we can help you rehab this. Surgery is not the only option, and you don't have to live with it, okay? So because there's little information, we're just going to start at the beginning of, like, what does it look like for a man to have a diastasis? And basically, the most overlying cause of diastasis is a muscle imbalance between the internal corset muscles and the external rectus abdominis muscle. So usually the external muscles, the rectus abdominis and the oblique muscles, are stronger or tighter, and the internal corset muscle is neglected, weak, thin, and inactive. Okay, and so there's a lot of tension pulling on the outside of the muscles, but not on the inside, the muscle that actually pulls you together and holds you up. So as a result, you tend to use, men and women, but tend to use strategies that push out on the abdominal wall repetitively as you tense up or hold your breath, or you strain and you brace, or you do a lot of collapsed positions that put a lot of continuous forward forceful pressure on the connective tissue, the linea alba. So when there's a lot of extra pressure on that connective tissue, it starts to stretch and stretch and stretch. And when the muscles aren't doing what they need to do to hold you back together, then it leads to a separation of your abdominal wall. Now recognize that it's not a hernia, it's not a tear, it's a separation, it's a stretch. But it still leaves the muscles in positions that are ineffective, and it can cause the abdominal wall to look weird and to function ineffectively. Okay, so what does it look like in men? We're going to kind of describe the probably four most common presentations that I see in men. The first one is fitness related. It seems to be really fitness related, and it's where the outer abdominal muscles are kind of overdeveloped from lots of crunches and sit-ups and lots of kind of really working the six-pack abs, and then there's a gap between the right and left side. And some people think that that gap between the middle is what's supposed to be there, and the bigger that is, the more defined it is. Actually, it's not. You're supposed to have the muscles pretty close together. You should see the line of connective tissue, but it shouldn't be more than one finger width. It shouldn't be wider, and it shouldn't go deep where the outer muscles are overdeveloped and pushing out, and the inner muscle is kind of a trench. Okay, when you have a trench or a severe gap, that's a recipe for disaster. And even though your abdominal wall might look strong, you don't actually have the internal stabilization of the corset muscle. So you could be dealing with all kinds of back pain, intestinal problems, pelvic instability, and much more. All kinds of things could be going on when that corset muscle isn't doing its job. The second presentation is more of a functional core weakness presentation. And this is usually over time, the abdominal wall has become less and less active, and you kind of have a poochy, almost pregnant looking, or kind of beer belly, that kind of everything feels a little like a deflated balloon. And as a result, sometimes you'll like get up out of bed, or you'll get off the couch and you'll see this bulge or this tenting or this football, or some people call it an alien, that kind of presses out down the midline and pushes out on your abdominal wall. That is another form of diastasis, and it's when it's pushing out like that, it's really you need to treat it because it can become a hernia. If you push out, push out, push out, eventually that connective tissue can tear, and then it can become very emergent, okay? So that bulging is not something that's normal. It's usually telling you that your muscles, the internal muscles, aren't doing any of the work, and you've learned a strategy of kind of powering through or holding your breath and kind of heaving yourself, and it pulls out. And you do that because you don't have another strategy, because the muscles aren't doing what they should be, and that's where we come in. We help you get those muscles doing what they should be. The third presentation, and sometimes these overlap, some of these presentations overlap. The third presentation is collapsed posture, kind of a rounding desk job, driving a lot, but a lot of kind of forward bending, rounding forward positions, that then when you stand up, your ribs actually flare. So it's a combination of really tight chest muscles, weak back muscles from collapsed rounded postures. And then the rib cage, which is where the corset actually attaches, is actually flared and causes overstretching of the connective tissue between the belly button and the sternum. So it kind of flares out, and now everything kind of bulges out in that. And that really gives you that presentation of almost a pregnant belly, because your belly starts so high up with that. And that's a lot of trying to work on not just the strength of the core, but also balancing out some of the muscle imbalances that we see in the upper part of the body. And often this is connected with the functional core weakness or with the muscle imbalance of the fitness stuff. There's not just one presentation, but, you know, they kind of overlap a little bit. And then the fourth presentation that we see a lot is some form of abdominal trauma, like a surgery or some kind of injury to the abdominal wall that might cause, there was maybe some cutting of tissues. There may have been some scar tissue in there, and now it can present either as a trench in the middle or a bulge with straining, either one of those or both of those. And that that also can be treated with functional core rehab that we do at the Tummy Team. But that's just another presentation that sometimes we will see. So it's not, you're not alone. If you're a guy and you're like, I've been diagnosed with this, or I think I have this weird alien sticking out of my stomach, or this unusual trench in my abdominal wall, and everything I've looked up is for women, I'm here to tell you that we have a program just for men. So we would love to help you. This helps you to understand what it looks like. We're going to do a couple other videos that are also going to share like some other things that are relevant to men that we'd love for you to check out. But you can also check out Core Foundations for Men at thetummyteam.com. And we have tons of resources for men and for women about what diastasis looks like and how it affects the body and how we can help you heal it and treat it without surgery. All right, thanks so much.